to you. Now you got a long way to go. Come on. Yeah, save the floor.
My sin is. Hold
on. Gone. Gone, okay? Ain't nothing I can do.
Oh, my feet so swole.
I'm nervous about the appointment meeting doctor now, that he's gonna think that my fat ways and my life is too much for him because of my ways. Because I choose to eat, because I choose to be overwhelmed by emotions and just feed myself to death. I'm hopeful that he's gonna get me on this program, but I'm more scared that he's gonna tell me no.
You ready, baby?
Is it a long walk?
It's a strong walk. It's not long, but it's strong. That means you gotta be strong, baby.
Do you wanna get the kids first?
Yeah, I'm finna get the kids right now.
Okay.
Come on. Come on, let's go. I'm gonna leave you, and you had to cut your. I gotta go. Come on, son. Hold the door for your mama.
You gonna stay with mama?
At one point, I thought I wanted to turn around, that I wasn't gonna be able to make it. I don't know if I'm gonna make it.
Baby, you got a couple of more. You want me to push you on this? I push you. Come on. Hold the door, son. Hold the door open. Hold the door open. I'm gonna push you. Since you can't take these last 5 steps, and you wanted that good old Louisiana chicken, here you go. There you go. Ride the cart. Ride the cart. You can't, this far, you can't go that far. So you gonna give up every time when Dr. No tell you about you can't eat this, you can't eat that. You gonna give up. You gonna give up. Here, there you go. Boom. Here, come on. I gotta help you up. Come on. You're gonna have to get in here. Come on.
Hold on, I gotta get myself together.
You wanna sit back down? No. Cause you sit back down, I'm not gonna help you up this time. You like to kill me. Okay, come on. What? It's a whole bathroom in there, son. It's a whole bathroom. It's a good bathroom. Come on, she make it. Come on, hey, self see. Come on now. Pat time for it. There you go. I don't know where I'm gonna sleep, but I'll be honest.
So I'm worried about my appointment with Dr. Now tomorrow. Because this is the last shot I have. So no matter what, tomorrow I'm gonna get up and keep going because I have to. Because if I walk away from this, my family could be planning my funeral.
Curb my appetite for the rest of the day. Right. I would lose some weight.
Okay.
We're all in Houston, but it took us driving over 4 hours straight to get here on time.
We here now.
I'm nervous.
Don't be nervous now. Come on, son.
Go ahead and get up, Simi.
Mirrors.
I'll hold that for you, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Come on. All right. Now, get on up and get out of here. Let's go. The queen has arrived.
I have a lot of fears that it's not going to be possible for me to get another weight loss surgery. Mainly because I've had one weight loss surgery already.
Ms. Hayes?
But I'm keeping a positive outlook that this is going to be something that's going to give me a second chance. On the road, I've said goodbye to the foods that I crave to bring me comfort. But from here on out, I'm doing what I have to succeed if I get this chance. Hopefully, my starting point isn't a lot higher than I expected.
Step up on the scale, please.
I think I should be around 600, so that's the range I'm expected to be at today. But if the number that comes up is higher, then that's going to be a hard moment for me when I see that.
Well, there it is. There you go.
What you mean by that?
There it is. Oh. There you go. You know what it is now.
I'm not happy about that weight, but I'm happy that it's not higher than I was thinking. But I'm ashamed that I let it get as high as it did. I know I did that to myself. And I'm praying that Dr. Now can do something, anything to help me change that and to lose weight. Because if he gives me the chance that I need, I'm ready to do whatever it takes to get on that right track.
Closing on up. Come on over here, have a seat. The Bucket Beaver, here, play with the beaver.
Hello, how y'all doing?
Fine, how are you?
Good. So, you must be Bianca.
Yes, sir.
All right, I'm Dr. Nazar, and you come in all the way from Fayetteville, Tennessee.
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, glad you're here. So, and who you got with you?
I have my son, Simeon, my daughter, Marcia, and my boyfriend, Ramonte.
It looks like the trip left Marcia a little tired and sleepy, huh?
Yes, she is.
So, tell me, what brought you down to Houston?
Because I wanted to see about getting a second chance at life with weight loss surgery.
Okay. And you had weight loss surgery about 4 years ago, huh?
Yes, sir. I had the gastric sleeve.
And then what happened after that?
I got pregnant with my daughter and fell back into old habits.
Okay, explain that more. What do you mean you fell into old habits?
Started back eating slider foods like chips, drinking soda. And my problem is I graze eat. Instead of eating a meal, I graze eat and just pick all day and just put stuff in my mouth all day.
Well, there's no operation is going to correct that.
So yes, sir.
What's going to be different this time if you have a second chance?
So I need to go through therapy and see, get down to the root of my emotional eating.
Well, hold on. What do you mean emotional eating?
I eat when I get upset, when I get stressed.
If you understand that, then why haven't you gone to therapy to address that before now?
I'm not sure.
So we need to get you away from giving yourself a pass to eat junk food. And that's typical. Everybody overeat and they have eating disorder. And they call it that, oh, I'm emotional eater. I'm happy, I eat. I'm sad, I eat. To give a pass for them to do that. But that's not reality. So the first step you're going to need to take to show me a second chance will be different for you is taking responsibility for your eating, not making any more excuse to yourself, and showing you're willing to put in the work that's going to take to change your life. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Well, you know, there is no second chance to get you successful unless you discipline yourself. Surgery is not going to correct your eating disorder.
Okay.
You are the one that they need to do that.